That is because every single woman is programmed to react to this type of behavior. And it's... What's going on, people? This is Alex, your dating coach. Today, we're going to talk about the type of behavior. This is what sets apart the guys that women don't respect versus the guys that women respect. And I can tell you something, man. I wish I knew this when I was younger. I swear to you, if there is one advice I would give my younger self, it is this one. Look, most guys, especially if you were raised by a single mother, and in general, from watching romantic movies, most guys think that to be attractive, you have to be romantic. Most guys think that to be attractive, you have to be super funny. You have to be the life of the party. Actually, no. The phrase, the loudest one is usually the one that knows the least, applies to women too. Women, don't get me wrong, women are attracted to charisma, right? They are attracted to charisma. Unfortunately, most guys are just not naturally charismatic, for they are outgoingness to be attractive. For most guys, it's actually less, which is more. Less is more. And I remember when I was a kid, we would watch the cool kids. The funny ones were the ones that were the class clowns. And we sort of think that to be most attractive, you have to attract all of the attention. It has the contrary effect. When you try to get attention, you actually deviate it. Unfortunately, it's pretty much the way you behave. The way you talk, the rhythm that you talk, the speed that you move, the speed of your reaction, and how much you focus, right? And the hint of coldness to your personality, which most guys try to not show coldness. But if you show some coldness also, mixed in with everything that I just said, some women will be a little intimidated, but not from a perspective of scared, but almost like when you're intimidated by somebody who is very serious. Yeah, I understand that intimidation is not a negative thing. That intimidation is pretty much that they're anxious at your coldness. And all they need is to see you smile for them to relax. It's that simple. We've all encountered people like that, where their attitude made us tense, where we don't know where we stand with them, right? So you could create that reaction in women and men. In fact, when you do this, men will respect you. When you do this, women will respect you, and some of them will have sex with you. Some of them, not all of them, you know what I'm saying, to be realistic. For example, I remember when I was playing basketball many years ago, and nobody respected me. People didn't like me. Nobody liked me, to be honest with you. And one day, I hurt my ankle, and so I was away from playing basketball for like a month. And for some reason, having that distance, in that month, I realized that a lot of people didn't like me. And then all of a sudden, I was like, yo, I'm not, when I go there next time, I'm not going to talk to them because they don't like me. Even when I talk to them, they talk to me because they just tolerated me. You know what I'm saying? It's like somebody who's annoying talking to you. You're like, you listen to them, you interact with them, but deep down, you don't respect them. That's pretty much what it was with me. And as soon as I did that, I came back and I just stopped interacting with people. I didn't say hi to anybody. I went straight up, practiced and played basketball and got better at it. And it got to the point where I was like one of the best players. Now, you know, it's a YMCA, but, you know, there's some good players there, to be honest with you. I mean, you have kids who play high school there sometimes. You know, those high school kids, I know a fucking joke. Like, what are you doing here? Go play with the fucking D1 players. What the fuck are you doing here ruining this game? And I just began not talking to people. You know what I noticed? Nobody talked to me. It's because they didn't like me. But over time, I began to mind my own business. When people would say something to me, I would respond with a little bit more seriousness. Like, hey, Deluxe's. Hey, what's up, man? How's it going? You good? Yeah, I'm chilling, bro. And you just walk away, right? What happens over time is that people will sort of begin to respect you. I don't know why, but your seriousness, they respect it. People respect serious people. You get what I'm trying to say? And with women, all you need is just their respect. The respect is the biggest part and the most important thing. If you have a woman's respect, as long as you kind of interact with her, don't hate on her. You play, this is more of the long game. And this happens, you could use this across almost everybody, to be honest with you. People will begin to see you as more competent, more attractive, more of a leader, right? Just because of your seriousness, because they can't read you. That don't mean you don't smile sometimes, but the times you really smile, it gets people's attention because they rarely see it. Now, if you're a happy person, just hold it in. Hold in that desire to express so much positivity. Become more neutral. When somebody says hi to you, you respond to them. You learn to have an economy of motion, an economy of words. And you don't goof around. Another thing, you don't goof around. You don't play around. If somebody goofs around, you goof around with them, but at a half of their intensity that they're showing. If you laugh, you don't laugh haha crazy. You might even laugh by saying that's funny, or even just laughing 50% of the intensity. The point is to reduce the amount of signals you send. Make yourself a little bit more mysterious. This doesn't apply to friends, but with acquaintances, this is what it applies, especially with women. And if you're competent at your job, people will sometimes, who don't even know you, sometimes will assume that you're of higher status than most people because of the way you carry yourself. You're so serious, you're so focused. You get the job done. And this applies to school and work, right? And so that actually a masculine vibe. That is actually masculinity, relaxedness, having boundaries, being a complete gentleman to every single person, right? And sometimes, for example, I remember there was this girl at the YMCA, and she said hi to me many years ago. She said hi to me, and I said hi to her, blah, blah, blah. We interacted. And when I would leave, she would say hi. She would say bye, you know, because, you know, you got to leave. And I would act like I didn't see her. But what's funny is that over time, she became extra, extra friendly to me. It actually happened to me one time when I talked to this guy at the sauna. And I talked to this guy at the sauna, and he was interacting with me. I thought he was gay because the way he was stretched right in front of me. I was like, dude, he just stretched in the opposite direction. And I thought he had a thing for me, to be honest with you. And then I will see him. The next time I will see him, I swear to God, this motherfucker never made eye contact with me ever again. Never. It's almost like I never even talked to him. And mind you, I'm a guy, straight guy. And that kind of like says, damn, dude, like, nigga, the fuck? Like, you act like we're not, you know, acquaintances now, man. And I can promise you, if he ever decides to say hi, I'm going to be extra receptive to him. Not suck his dick, but you know what I'm saying? To be polite, to be engaged in conversation, right? Because you sort of feel neglected in a weird way. And so you could be serious with people. And sometimes you say, hey, man, I can't. And somebody tries to have a quick conversation. You say, hey, man, I can't talk right now. I gotta finish this. You create some boundaries. And even though it kind of offends them, it does offend them, but they will forgive you. And they will come for you, for your validation next time. Right? And that is a way to project masculinity. Another thing that you got to learn is to talk a little bit more slower. Talk a little, not in slow motion, but like slow it down a little bit. I learned that myself. For example, if you usually talk like this to people and you want to communicate it properly, right? You speak fast, right? You want to talk like this a little bit more, right? If somebody talks to you, if somebody says, hey, Alexis, you don't say, for example, this is responses, right? One, somebody says hi, you respond, right? If somebody says, hey, Alexis, right? You don't go like, hey, Alexis, hey, what's up? Instead, you want to be, hey, Alexis, hey, what's up, right? And you also learn about the economy of motion, right? Somebody says, hey, Alexis, hey, what's up, man, how you doing? Rather than, hey, Alexis, hey, what's up, man, how are you? You learn to have an economy of motion, an economy of words, and that comes through practice. Learn to have a slower response, milliseconds. It's not noticeable enough, but it creates the effect, right? And it just comes across as a very competent, confident, masculine person when you do that. With women, it'll come across as feminine. You know what I'm saying? When you control yourself and you slow things down, for the sexes, it comes across as a full reflection of themselves. For men, it'll come across as masculine to women. If a woman does this, it'll come across as feminine to us, but in a very respectful way. Not girly, I don't respect you feminine, but strong feminine, you know? And this way of us talking is a strong masculine, not an insecure masculine, where it's always trying to get in people's way. That is ego-fueled. It's more relaxed, okay? And that is the way that you women would just absolutely love this type of behavior, okay? All right, I hope this video made a lot of sense to you guys. This is Alex. I'll see you guys in the next video, okay? Wait a minute, guys. Okay, so if you consider yourself a nice guy, if you're the type of person that always tries to, always gets played by women, is considered like a mama's boy, or you like assertiveness, or you've been bullied when you were a little kid, and so you develop some nice guy's tendencies, then I would highly recommend you check out my new course, Nice Guy. It's specifically made for just nice people in general. I'm a nice guy. I was a nice guy. I was a Bible teacher, for God's sake. I was a Bible teacher. It doesn't get any more nicer than that, okay? So in this course, I will teach you about the art of assertiveness. And if you just learn to become more assertive in a healthy and non-toxic way, what will happen is that men will respect you and women will bang you for the most part, okay? As long as women respect you and see you as a man, that's all that matters. So this course is more about how to embrace your masculine side. If a guy watches this, he'll embrace his masculine side. If a woman watches this, they'll embrace their feminine. This is a course specifically made to bring out your assertive self in a healthy way. So you're gonna learn about the source of human aggression. You're gonna learn about how to assert yourself in terms of in a work situation, what to do if somebody disrespects you, how to know if somebody is disrespecting you or not. Because when you're a nice person, you assume that everybody has good intentions. So you can check out all of this. It's a pretty big course, but the size of the course, it doesn't matter. You can check out all of this for just $99. And if you don't like it, just ask for your money back, and I'll send you your money back. No questions asked. Not one time in my career have I ever rejected somebody's refund. So if you don't like it, it's a money back guarantee. This is the equivalent of buying a sneaker, okay? It's a really good investment. So I'll see you guys inside. It's a 30-day money back guarantee, and you will not regret it, because after this course, you will learn how to become more assertive, and women will stop playing you. It's plain and simple, and that's all that matters. I'll see you guys inside.